The whole album cover with the diamond on is really what it is. It's just like diamonds are made from coal. You know what I mean? But that comes from a lot of pressure and a lot of things on top of it to make it come out. And when it comes out, it's shining. And you know, the diamond is not something you just go out here and crush with a rock. It's hard, it's tough. But at the same time, it's bright. And that's me. I don't really do the chains and shit no more. And I think with that is just because that's all I knew. That was a symbolization of being, you know, paid at the time, which was really real money. You know what I mean? You would walk around with all these chains and things on is that would make you important. But here nowadays, when you're in the room with these CEOs and you're in the room with these people that really make the world go around, it's just like, you know, for you to walk in with all that shit on is like, it's almost a confirmation that you ain't ready to be in that room. That's where I was coming from. But you know, as time I've evolved, you know, I've learned and I've seen things that hold way more value, that actually appreciate in value. I'm more into creating, you know, self-wealth, you know what I mean? It's just like, when you're in the rat race, like you just running around, so you're just trying to be in the nows and the whats, but it's like, you gotta be willing to do the things now to have the things that people won't have later on because they're not willing to do that. Life is distracting, you know what I mean? Like, you know, you look around and things are going on, you think these people are doing well, you think that is like, so you don't really know what's going on, but you have to just step back from everything and take that time to say, okay, this is what I want to do. This is how I'm going to go about it. And it might not move as fast as everything that's around you, but you got to really believe that that's what's, you know, that's what's in store for you so you can, you know, you can even get there. When you look at the album, you look at, you know, the cover, you look at Trust Your Process, it's like, we're going to try to live our best lives we could possibly live, you know what I'm saying? No matter what we go through, no matter what comes across our table, no matter what comes, you know, gets put on our desk. It's all a part of, like, believing in yourself and just believing that, you know, if you take the time to focus, that you can actually get things done that you wouldn't think that you can do. You have all the resources, you can have all the support. But if you don't believe, you know, 10 times out of 10, it ain't gonna happen. I done some things where, you know, I had to learn by trial and trial, but, you know, I pride myself on understanding that, you know what I'm saying, you don't know everything, you're gonna have to learn. Whatever weaknesses you have, you gotta put people in place that can help, can cover you on that, to make sure that you're at 100%. But at the same time, you still gotta trust in your decisions. When you hear people say certain things or have their opinion about how you moving or how you rocking, it doesn't matter, bro, because at the end of the day, if I'm doing great or if I'm doing worse, you know, you're just gonna have an opinion. You ain't gonna have any advice. You ain't have any resources for me. You don't have any outlets. You don't have any connections. You're just speaking what you feel. This morning I've been on a lot of Pac, you know what I'm saying? Because like sometimes I find myself wanting to hear things from somebody like-minded. When it comes to just, you know, life and being rebellious and being a rebel, you know, I just think, you know, I can relate to Tupac in so many ways because he was ahead of the time. So a lot of things he said then still matter now. You know, every now and then I might catch a gem that I didn't even catch, you know, back then. I'm like, oh, yeah, that's what's up. So it just lets you know he's a part of culture that's never going to die because people are always going to keep him alive in their words and just out of respect because he stood on what he believed in and he wasn't the guy that was following the trend. You know, everybody's trying to ride a wave or surf a tide, I don't know, some shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, so it's just like, but that to me feels like, you know, there's, you're not being an individual. What made him stick to his guns even when the way he was coming wasn't really the way, you know, people were coming back to him. Everybody was lyrical, everybody was, you know, suave, or everybody had their own little niche. But he was the only one standing on, you know, something solid. I can have a conversation with you and be straight up and I don't have to be like, you know, a rapper about it. You know what I'm saying? Come here with my cup of lean. You know what I mean? Do my 1-2 thing, you know what I mean? Like, it ain't that. It's like, it's all the same to me. Music, real life music. Tupac was a revolutionary, man. He was iconic, he was icon. You know what I'm saying? He happened to know where he wanted to go. Somebody just, you know, didn't let him get there, but he was headed there, one way or another. When he left a big gap, and nobody really tried to really step in and fill the voids of the rules and the regulations, and it's just like, everybody that came, everybody had their own rendition and shit, but then when it got about the money, they kind of forgot about the people. He always thought about the people until the day he was no more. It ain't really nobody out here really fighting for the people and getting the people, you know, no hope and getting the people some insight on what's going on. It's more so like everybody for self and everybody just want to, you know, kick it how they kick it because it's a wave. I got a family member that's she's a nurse. And just to hear the stories, you know, she might call and say, I'm like, you good? Oh man, we had 5 kids come in and overdosed on, you know, this and that. I'm just like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? Like Percocet, I was just like, wow, that's crazy. You know what I mean? In one day, you had 5 kids come in and die. She's like, yeah, one 13-year-old. I'm just like, man, that's crazy to me. But they're listening to the music. I can get it if that's your vice and that's what you like doing. We're going to respect that. But once your words get out and you're telling people that this is it and that's how it is, like, I don't know if I can respect that. Okay, the music is cool, but like, what you stand for though? If I had a conversation with you, like, you're gonna be too doped up to tell me something cool? You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be too high to really, you're gonna be, like, I can't follow you to the end of the earth. Like, for one, you don't even know what the fuck you talking about. These people are leaders. I don't think they understand that. You know, and it's one thing to be a culture vulture and get in and then get your money, but don't act like, you know, you the realest thing since, you know, Machiavelli, Scarface, or Jeezy, or Boosie, or T.I. You know what I'm saying? It's like, these are stand-up guys, man. These guys are living legends. Pimp C died, you know, drinking lean. That was an indicator right there. That's one of our legends. You know, you would think he would have went out in a hell of gunfire. You know what I'm saying? Just what he stood for. But look at that shit. That was an indicator to me right there. I don't never need to. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? You see me with a styrofoam cup, it might be some Diet Coke in that motherfucker. You feel me? With some ice. But I'm not drinking that shit. It's important for me to come, you know, when I come, when it's too much and it's too ignorant. It takes people like me to step in and say, look, that's cool, man, but you could do this also over here. American Dream, and it's jamming, by the way. Powerful, very powerful. Everybody came and did their thing, man. Everybody showed up and showed out. Like, this is for real right here, especially with everything that's going on in the world. It's gonna touch close to a lot of homes, man. And especially in the time right now in the world where, you know, everything's really tricky, iffy. You don't really know what's what anymore. To hear some Three Kings come together and really talk that talk, that's what it needed. It's definitely black excellence, and this is definitely one for the culture. You know, black excellence to me is just about knowing your position in this and how you can help your brother out and giving each other outlets to, you know, just overcome some of the things that we go through as a people and as a community. And I think that's what makes excellence. And we out here doing a great job at it. You know what I'm saying? You got me and some billionaires and we doing all this off of hustle. My brother got something dope, he got an idea, we gonna make it come through for him. You know what I'm saying? That's what black excellence is about, just looking out for your brother, looking out for your sister, and just making sure that we come out on top.